everyone.
Hi,
Alice.
Hi, Alice.
I want to ask a question. That have you read Little Red Riding Hood, Peter Pan, or like The Sleeping Beauty? Have you read any one of that?
Yes.
So you will know they are very tall stories, but do you know about analytical psychology? So you may come up with a question. What is the connection between them? So, and that is today's topic, psychology of fairy tale. And I want to introduce this person. He was drunk because he died. And he was an analytical psychiatrist. What is analytical psychology? It is about development of... No, this is his picture. Development of masculine and feminine. And I want to take the... Do you know what is this? What fairy tale story? Can you tell from this picture?
Yeah,
and I want to take Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs for example. And in the beginning scene, the mother sits at the window. She is embroidering, and she makes the future promise that she wishes her child to be. Her skin as white as the snow, and her eyes and hair as black as the needle in her hand. And also she pricks her fingers and she drops a blood, and she thinks she wants her child's cheeks to be as red as the blood. And after she gives birth, she dies from giving birth to her child. So what do these things tell us? And the king, who is the indolent father, he represents the immature masculine because he does not protect her child. She does not protect her child. And the death of the mother represents the denial of the feminine. The feminine does not have the chance to develop herself. And then what's going next? The king married a new wife, the evil queen, and she sends a huntsman to kill Snow White. But he did not kill her. He brings back a dear heart instead to like deceive the evil queen. And the evil queen always asks her magic mirror, who is the most beautiful girl in the world, and the mirror always answers her. It is no fight. And so here the stepmother represents the wicked feminine character in the psyche, which always like damage the man feminine. And the husband, who is less harmful than the first masculine character, but he does not do any help for her. And the magic mirror represents the self-identification that the evil queen always has the mirror. So she depends her self-identification on the mirror's answer. And then Snow White flees into the woods and his man and he made 70 bucks in a college. And then they tell her not to open the door and let the stranger in. But she does not let the stranger in from the door, but instead she lets the evil queen enter from the window. So here the 70 dwarfs represent the mass majority of the men, and they are half men size. So they fail to protect the men feminine character also. And the cortex represent the temporary sex, but it is actually a mess, which represents the mess in the human psyche. And the stepmother, she showed up in disguise, which means that the human psyche of the person did not recognize the evil part in his or her psyche. And then the seven dwarfs feel like she is dead. And the prince comes and he kisses her face and she comes to life. So they make a united, they get married. So here the prince represents the only mature masculine in this doctrine. I think the time is...